was sitting in my room and I was thinking about life. Like I was thinking, I'm in a good college. My family, I'm very happy with them. I have friends and everything is so perfect. But I was still not happy with my life. I was thinking there's something missing. There's something missing which I need to find out. And then I thought, maybe aren't we all supposed to like stick with this life and take tension and know like the same life is going. So then I thought there must be some people who have gained that knowledge and who are so happy and help everyone and loved by everyone. Then I thought, who are these people? Then I was thinking, okay, these are these legendary teachers, Buddha, Ram, Jesus and Muhammad. These were awesome. These were like, from my side, they are cool and they have such a knowledge. We all praise and they used to help everyone. Everyone used to love them. And what was the special thing about these guys? Aren't these guys were made from flesh and bones like us? So why aren't these guys have this knowledge came from and why aren't we are like this? So then, after so many months, I'll just keep thinking about these guys. What is the secret? What is the secret behind these guys? What is that? So then one day it occurred to me, Buddha left his kingdom on one fine day and went out in the world to see what's going out there and want to learn and share his teaching. Jesus used to move from land to land and used to help people and wherever he can teach Ram. Ram was left his kingdom for an exile of 14 years in a jungle, and then that 14 years gave him the experience of his lifetime. Muhammad was the last prophet sent by the God to travel around, meet people and give them preaching. So what is the most common thing in all of these four legendary teachers? They were awesome, they were cool, but there was something common which I found out, and that was my answer to all the questions. They all were travelers. And maybe all of them wanted to tell us one thing and teach us and convey this message by the stories that we should go out in the world, see people, see different cultures and learn from them and become a better person. So now, 15 months back, I was thinking about the same thing and I was sitting in my college room. It was 2 a.m. and there was a party going on and everyone was enjoying it. But I was like, I don't know, now I got the answer and what I'm doing with my life. I need to go out. So I took a decision which changed my life forever. I took my cycle, I took my bag, I just left my college at 2 a.m. Then I was out, I was like, okay, I have to go somewhere, which direction? So I was like, okay, let's go south. Then my journey began. I cycled for 58 days, 3,200 kilometers, and I met so many people, seen so many cultures and places I never seen, and learned so many things. In this trip, I decided I won't take a hotel because I wanted to meet people, so I wanted to stay outside. So I stayed in mandirs, in masjid, in petrol pumps, even I slept on the roadside. And yes, this journey taught me so many things and I met so many beautiful people around me. And then in the end, after 58 days, when I reached the last southern point of India, Kanyakumari, then I was like, okay, the journey has ended. But I don't know, maybe it's not the end, maybe it's the beginning of a new thing. So I came back to my college and I was really happy in my life. I was a complete changed person. I was like, maybe I got it, maybe this is it. And then I was so excited for a few days that I used to go around, meet people, and everyone says, you have changed a lot, and I can feel it. But then after a few months in college, I was back in my life, working in my laptop, and I was like, oh, what is happening? Now I have to go out again. Because I was hungry for the knowledge I gained a few months back, and I need to go out. But this time, I need to choose a terrain which is tough, maybe the toughest, and so I can gain more knowledge. So I just sat and opened the world map and saw this. And I decided my next destination is the Great Himalayas. So on 28 April 2015, my journey started. So it began from Arunachal. And then the first week I was staying in a Gurudwara. It was such a simple life. I was staying with the family, I was washing dishes, I was cooking food, I was even standing on the gate as a security guard and serving water to all the people going by. And then I was invited to so many schools around in Assam to teach about environment and sustainable tourism. There was giving speech to them. And then I crossed a lot of hurdles, like I crossed forests. And then after a month in traveling in Assam and Arunachal, I reached the most happiest place on earth, Bhutan. Trust me, Bhutan is the most amazing place I have been. I have learned so many things from these places. The people I met, they are so happy with their life. They're helping. Like when I reached Bhutan, it was the first country I had ever been. I went to the gate and I was stopped by the police. And then the immigration officer came and then I sat with him and then we discussed, okay, I'm going to enter. Then he only took me around the place and then he bargained with the hotel guy for me. And then he chose which room to stay and he used to come every day in the morning to see if I'm having a good time. So it was a learning for me. And there were different people I met. So this courage to give me to go to the tiger's nest in the North Bhutan is one of the most beautiful places, Bhutan, where you have to trek for 15 kilometers. So now I'm like, okay, I want to go there, it's beautiful. But then I was like, no. Maybe I will go there but with my cycle, which is with me for the entire trip. Then I trekked 15 kilometers up in the mountain with the cycle on my shoulders. I was that tired, I took 10 hours to reach there, but in the end, it was beautiful for me. After that, I left Bhutan and then through Sikkim, I was going to enter Nepal. And Nepal just got hit by an earthquake and it was devastating. And then I was getting calls from my parents and of my relatives that you don't have to go do this, finish your journey right now, you have to go now. So many things are happening, you have to come back. And then I was like, maybe I should, but from inside I was like, no, I have to finish this. Then I entered Nepal and in 10 days of continuous cycling, I reached Kathmandu. And I see a lot of things happen there which make you feel bad. So much destruction happened and so many people died. And then I was like, I have to stay here and I have to do something for these guys. Then I stayed there and I worked with two NGOs. And then in the span of 10 days, with continuous walking, we built 20 temporary shelters. So we used to walk day and night, these guys in the villages, and then we built this 20 shelters from the basic materials like tin and iron rods. And we taught the same technique to a lot of villagers and school kids. And they were pretty happy about it. And then I reached Uttarakhand through this suspension bridge. This is one of the longest suspension bridge in Nepal. And then my journey began from Uttarakhand to Kathmandu, from 100 meters above sea level to 5,600 above sea level. So now the journey was tough and every day you just go up, there's no downhill. And it was raining, it was cold, but I had to do this. And I was carrying around 40 kgs of weight on the back of my cycle, including the film equipment and all the stuff. And then I reached Manali Highway and there's so many things happened there. It was tough terrain and I have sinus, so I can't breathe properly, but above 3000 meters sea level, you can't breathe properly because the oxygen level is too low. And then I got hit by AMS and I was admitted in hospital. Then the doctor told me not to go further because it will be harmful, it can cause death also. So I just ran from the hospital and continued my journey. It was cold, yeah. I almost got flushed away by the cold icy water. This is me, just before Kathmandu, and I was like, okay, I think I'm dying now. Because I got 4 blackouts, but I need to do this, I was pushing myself. And finally, I reached Ladakh, the dream place of all the travelers, and the next day, I tried my journey for Kathmandu, 40 kilometers uphill, the most deadliest uphill I ever had in my life. And this was it. So after there, I started my journey to Kargil. The roads were crazy dangerous. But I didn't feel any fear or any toughness. I was happy, and in the end, I was literally, my tears were coming out, I was cycling down, I was screaming Julie, Julie to everyone, because Julie in Ladakhi means hello, goodbye and thank you. And then on 30th July 2015, my 6,000 kilometer journey in 405 days and 3 countries finished. No, so now I want to share a small film of my journey with you guys. In the future, most of our tourism places will be gone. Increases in price. Overuse of the natural resources. We are destroying the very paradise we see. So, these facts say that, now once I am saying, traveling is awesome. It's the best teacher you'll ever have. And that's why I say traveling and tourism, these things are killing the world. It's creating a very big negative impact. So let's save the world by traveling the right way. So right way is first, the most important thing, support local economy. So the biggest problem when you say economic equality is the previous fact that you spend $100 and only $5 is going in the pockets of the local people. So the local people are the one who's making the paradise for you. So when you travel to a place, these are the one who's making the entire experience for you, not those big companies. So when you go out there, spend as much as possible on these people, on local food, on local guest houses, on local crafts and everything. Because these are the things which are creating this experience for you and making you a better person. Prepare, always prepare for your trip. If you're going to somewhere, don't just like go, but read about what is going on in that place, what things you can do to help them out, what problems they are facing, and all. Respect local people and the culture. Conserve resources. Be aware, when you go out, don't just go to a hotel also and just use the water as much as you want or electricity as you want. Because it is costing the locals a lot. So you have to keep in mind how much resources is using by your visit. Therefore, if we make the right choices while traveling, so traveling can make us a better person and this world a better place. Thank you.